Everyone's expecting me to throw the biggest party for my 21st. So I'm super excited. I feel like my whole life's been leading up to this moment. Let me see. I actually like that. Now it's daylight saving, so we get like more time because I usually sleep in and like I miss golden hour, so yay. It's such a good day for us, like so glad. My 21st is just like what it's all been leading up to, and this is gonna be the biggest party. I've literally been partying like since I was maybe 16 and throwing massive birthday parties for myself. I'm best known for my party vlogs on my YouTube channel and my photos on Instagram. I imagine it to be like an outdoor party with a pool and then have everybody outside dancing and wearing something elegant. So my parents have never actually seen me party or get drunk like in real life. They just see it on YouTube. Hope they have fun and don't get too overwhelmed at my 21st. Our life. I'm on my way to pick up my dream Chihuahua, bro.
Yay!
Been waiting for this moment. I feel like every baddie needs to have a Chihuahua. It's just an accessory, you know. I can't see them.
Oh, stop over there.
Oh my god.
Oh my god. Hello, I'm a Misha. Oh my god, nice to meet you. He's so cute. Yes, please.
I promise I'll look after him so much. He'll have the best life ever. Like, we've bought him so much stuff and like he's gonna be so spoiled. Like, I promise you, he's already on TV. Everybody, look at my Chihuahua. Yay! Look at my Chihuahua!
Oh god, it's gorgeous! Oh, yeah. Oh, and you look fabulous too.
Thank you! Hi, welcome to my crib. Come inside. Here's our alcohol collection. This is my favorite one. I got this as a gift for my birthday. It says Misha and Barbie. This is my stripper pole. And yeah, period. I put it up myself, me and my flatmate. It's pretty hard to put up yourself. But yeah, we did that. And this is the door handle from my car. So one time I crashed it, like after like driving home from town. And I'm like, can I keep the door? But then my mum wouldn't let me keep the door. So I got to keep the handle. Yay! Can't wait to see what's inside. Long term, if I could make influencing my full-time thing, that's the dream. Fashion Nova basically sends me like 10 items per month in exchange for me making like a whole dedicated YouTube video slash like try on haul for them. Last month I was working with this New Zealand brand, and not only did they send me the product, but they also sent me like $250 just to post like a photo of me in the product. Overall, I feel like you can pay the rent with it, but like you can't like buy more things. It's just like standard rent money, you know, like, so I have like a side job as well, just to like, you know, make sure I can like, you know, afford like the quality of life. Welcome to Femme Fatale. Since influencing isn't my full-time job at the moment, I currently work here as a bartender. In 2018, when I just finished high school, that was when my influencer career was really taking off. Like, I went to LA and I was in a Snoop Dogg music video that was on Worldstar.
This video is gonna be a behind the scenes of a Snoop Dogg music video.
Yeah, now I can't be doing that because of COVID. Honestly, like, I'm happy in Auckland. Like, it's cute, and like, I know everyone, like, everyone knows me or whatever, but like, obviously, like, I'm a bit bored of it. I feel like I've done everything here, and like, I'm ready for like, the next chapter, you know? Hello, could I please get the mac and cheese bites and could I get 4 frozen cokes, the raspberry ones?
Look at your nails. I'm gonna get them painted.
Like mommy.
Thank you. The last few weeks I've just been getting heaps of like hate for like this party I attended.
COVID rules are 25 people outside.
People are just acting like I went to that influencer party that was in the North Shore that was all over the news, but it was nothing like that. There was not 26 people, not 27, there was only 25. And yeah, everyone was back, so I don't see the problem.
Do you understand that the restrictions at the time stated that you couldn't have indoor gatherings, no matter how many people you did have?
Yeah, I get why people are mad though, because like technically like this was breaking the rules by having 25 people inside, not outside. Just the extent they went to, that was just so unnecessary. They started posting about something I said like nearly 5 years ago.
Brands like Culture Kings didn't know about her racism, etc. But now that they do, well, never.
When I was maybe 17, I wrote this post about just saying like, I'm so embarrassed to be Indian, like Indians are so like embarrassing and fugly and hairy. And like I used like really harsh terms like that. And somebody on that account screenshotted it and it just went viral. I was just ashamed of like what I said. And I'm like, I can't believe like this, I even said this, like what the hell? Like, I'm not a racist. Like, I'm just a brown girl that was just brought up in New Zealand thinking like white people are the beauty standard. If you read the comments on all those posts, they're all positive. They're saying like, she's clearly evolved. She's apologized. She's embracing her culture with her family on Diwali, like posting in Indian clothes and you're embracing her culture. The studio and we're making a song. I just feel like half the time when I'm like taking photos and stuff and just driving around, I'm like, sure, I can imagine this like being in a music video. And to have a music video, you gotta make a song, so that's what we're doing. Yay!
Yeah, that one was pretty good, but I think you need to come with more energy, like you had all the notes okay. On time, but
true.
You know, just say it with your chest a bit more.
Okay, period. One more time. So I was born in New Delhi in India and I moved to New Zealand when I was just one. I feel like my relationship with my parents at this very moment is really good. It's probably at its best right now. For like the past 3 years wasn't really good, like with me transitioning into like my influencer career or whatever. It was just hard for them to like accept the fact that I'm not going to uni, I'm not doing this like stereotypical like, you know, life path.
We'll chuck a bit of like automation clip on this little bit, you know, get it turned up. The whole filter,
cool.
Get the whole filter.
Earlier last year, India had like a massive case of COVID. Unfortunately, my grandparents both passed away due to COVID. So it basically just made like me and my parents realize that like we're literally the only family we have in New Zealand. So, you know, it just kind of just brought us closer together. If they were at my 21st, I would just love to like see the look on their faces. Like I would just throw it all at them saying, I'm starting a rap career, I do YouTube, here's my YouTube channel. I'd just love to see like my grandma's reaction, but yeah.
I'm happy.
Love you. Love you.
Love you. Love you. Love you.
Love you.
Love you. Love you. Love you. Love you.
I think my daughter is very, very bright, a very beautiful, intelligent child. That we made the right move to bring her here.
Misha has me and Amit as her only family, and that is why I'm going to be behind my daughter no matter what happens in life. And so this is our way of supporting her. With whatever decisions she makes, we will be there to cover her back.
I'm so happy, so happy. The
this party is literally like everything I dreamed of. I feel like an adult because like when I was younger I didn't get freedom, so I feel like freedom really associates with like adulthood. So like I'm free, I can wear whatever I want, I can be whoever I am, I can say whatever I want, I'm an adult.